son, and the Dean Vice Chancellor of Katowice University, and also a husband of Phil Anka.
I'm Carolina, and I play Maria Robin's daughter, an advocate for climate change action.
I'm Angela, I'm playing the role of grandma and patient's grandmother. My name is Lara.
I'm Sam Bagano, I'm playing patient's graduate student from the University of Katowice.
And I'm Daniel Mochai from Oxfam. And we are going to do a little bit of a sampler of what we did yesterday. So our question was, how can the theater, how can performance arts help to transform gender relations, particularly in the backdrop of climate change? Can that happen? How can we do it? So we used a methodology that is a theater of the oppressed, where after we played the whole session, then the people from the audience participated. We don't have time for this today, but maybe, who knows, in the next D&C Days, next year. So, we'll be speaking very loud, very clear, and if you need to come a bit closer from the back, please do. So let's give our fantastic actors here a cue. 3, 2, 1, action!
I'm so glad you are here for my graduation, Grandma. You came all the way from Nairobi.
Of course, sweet patients. I would never miss an opportunity to come to Katowice.
I didn't imagine that studying climate change would be my entry point for feminism. But now I know the climate change fight is about emancipation, Grandma.
Can you believe? 1.5! It's outrageous!
Yes, 1.5 is difficult to digest, but it offers hope as well, Grandma.
Where's the hope in paying 1.5 euros for a coffee this morning at the airport? It's a ripoff, 1.5?
Come on. Oh, look, these are important people.
As the Dean Vice Chancellor of Katowice University, it is my duty to keep this institution running, Phil, and that means I have to be pragmatic and bring the money in at any cost.
I swear, Roberto, if it wasn't because you are my husband, and I know behind this pragmatic horror, there is a great man, I would have lost faith in you.
But why are you always obtuse? To be honest with you, Phil, I don't like them either. But if it wasn't my deals with Monsanto and the money we get from the Global Bank, the climate change department wouldn't have been finished. And who would pay for a professorship, huh?
Dean Roberto, so nice to see you. I've just given a speech at your School of Business. Did I overhear you tell Professor Phil Langer that our money from the Global Bank oversees professorship on ethics and gender? That can't be. We would never fund that fluffy stuff. We focus on things that add value.
My good friend Fonzarigina. The wind must have twisted my words. Anyway, I have good news, and I know you want to hear it. It's about renaming the library.
Oh, yes.
I should propose.
Oh, great. I can almost see it already.
Maria Robin's daughter, my savior. I'm so glad to see a person of integrity finally. You, wonderful advocate of climate justice. I need some inspirational words, or I may perish of my helplessness. Please.
Well, it's very simple, my dear Professor Phil Anger. Don't let them confuse you. Some think of climate change action as a conundrum. Some do. But is it a conundrum at all? No, of course it isn't. It's not, certainly. Instead, it's one of the clearest moments in history. The direction is clear. Hence, no conundrum. No conundrum, Phil. Feeling better already?
Say that again.
Okay, let me try this. Fossil fuel companies have lost their legitimacy. Their social licenses to operate have expired. It is a human rights violation to continue underappreciating the work of women in the family, in agriculture, in the workplace. It can't continue, and we won't.
see the light! I'm cured!
Thank you, Mrs. Robin's daughter! I'm in!
Maybe not going to the university was okay.